Red Dragon is a readaptation of the novel of the same name, which essentially makes it a remake of Manhunter. You might wonder what the point is, but believe it or not, a lot of people wanted this, as there would finally be an adaptation of the first novel of the series that had Anthony Hopkins as Hannibal. In retrospect, it really is sort of unnecessary, as all it does is further bury Manhunter, which was a perfectly good film. But does that mean that Red Dragon is bad? Remember, being unnecessary does not mean that a film is of poor quality, and Red Dragon is not of poor quality. You already know the plot if you saw my review of Manhunter, so I won't recount it here. You of course have Hopkins as Hannibal Lecter, and this time around Will Graham is played by Edward Norton, and Francis Dolarhyde is played by Ralph Fiennes. And the film is directed by Brett Ratner. So, how does it compare to Manhunter? Well, while both are very close to the book, Red Dragon is closer, including more of the scenes with Dolarhyde and giving him more motivation and character development, and the twist ending of the novel is present in this film, whereas it was truncated to a simpler resolution in Manhunter. The film also doesn't use rock music for its score, instead relying on a symphonic score by Danny Elfman. The acting is top-notch this time around, as expected, though I prefer Manhunter's Will Graham. Edward Norton is a fine actor, but he doesn't seem burnt out. You don't get the sense that he's been through a lot. Also, there's an additional scene in the beginning that details how Graham caught Lecter, which was relayed as flashbacks in the middle of the book, but is added as an intro here, which I rather liked. There's also a new epilogue to set up The Silence of the Lambs, which I felt was unneeded. So basically, out of the two, Red Dragon is a better adaptation of the novel than Manhunter is. However, Manhunter in some ways is a better movie, because of the dark atmosphere, superior directing, and the music. Red Dragon does a better job portraying Dolarhyde, while Manhunter did a better job portraying Will Graham. Hopkins is a better Hannibal Lecter than Brian Cox, but there's almost too much of him in this movie. Part of what made the character interesting in the book and in Manhunter was that he was used sparingly. So basically, whether to choose Manhunter or Red Dragon is simply put a matter of taste. They both adapt the same story and take different approaches to it. Red Dragon follows the novel a lot better, but Manhunter has more style and savvy. Red Dragon integrates itself with Silence of the Lambs and Hannibal much better, but Manhunter is more unique and stands on its own better. Red Dragon overall comes off either better or worse, depending on if you view it as a remake or a readaptation. If you view it as a readaptation, it's the superior effort, but if you view it as a remake of Manhunter, it's unnecessary and seems more formulaic. Overall, they're both good films, and I'd say watch them both and decide for yourself which you prefer, because in my mind, their flaws and triumphs balance each other out, making them equals. 8 out of 10. It really is a toss-up for me.